Ya, cheese is back.
Yep. Well, this week, Pork and I become a little bit more awesome as Mitch Dulce teaches us how to Lindy hop.
So I'm going to teach you guys Lindy hop. The first thing to do is to just make sure that your stance is like level. And then the key to a good Lindy hop is to keep your knees bent at all times. So your posture should always be like knees bent. Imagine that. And then you do step, step, triple step. Step, step, triple step. Step, step, triple step. So shoulders level. Park, don't do hands. And, so yeah, just shoulder level and then don't bounce. I think you're too eager.
Okay.
So, let's try it again.
Okay.
Okay.
Okay, no hands.
Okay. Step, step, triple step. Step, step, triple step. Step, step, triple step. Hands.
Step, step. You know, windshield.
Yeah.
Thank you so much. That's it.
No, that's kind of the basic step, and then you do it in pair. So when you partner up, you do the mirror. So I start with my right, and you start with your left.
Okay.
And then this is the step. So hand on waist.
Okay.
There. Woohoo! Yeah. Okay, so step, step, triple step. Step, step, triple step. Step, step, triple step. Step, step, triple step. Okay, yeah. Good job, Corey.
Five.
Five, six, seven, eight. Step, step,
triple step. Step, step, triple step. Step, step, triple step.
That's the one.
Triple step.
Perfect.
Woohoo! Week in and week out, Pork sits down with two of the sexiest musical connoisseurs in the country, Erwin Romulo and Kim Marvilia. Let's do it. Here's your quickie.
Welcome to Quickie, where we discuss today's pressing topics in music with our musical experts, including UNO Editor-in-Chief Erwin Romulo, and former NU DJ and current DJ, Ms. Kim Marvilia. All right. Our topic for today is dead musical genres. Let's discuss. Are there any dead musical genres that you want to talk about?
Music itself.
I somehow knew Erwin was going to say that.
How about punk? Is punk dead?
Yeah, punk died in 1968.
So what about all of those graffiti that say punk is not dead?
Oh, well, it's like gout.
Okay.
It never really goes away.
Okay.
So, you know, it resurges. I mean, punk essentially is dead.
Hmm. But Kim says she's a punk.
She's not.
I'm not aware what show this is that I just guessed it on.
Kim's not a punk.
I think it's hard to categorize yourself as a punk, especially that we're not really in that generation anymore. But I like punk, but more in SoCal punk, which I think Erwin hates. So, you know.
Would you count SoCal punk as punk?
I'd call it white. too much, you know, California sun, mall kids, whiny music.
Okay.
It's like Britney Spears, the same thing. Okay. Or it's like Debbie Gibson.
So Britney Spears and Blink-182.
Yeah, they all came from the mall. Okay. So they should all go back to the mall where they came from.
Yeah.
You like soccer? You like the pioneers of emo, Sunny Day,
USA,
right?
I don't think they're punk. I think punk has kind of become a joke in the sense that it's kind of become a caricature.
Right.
So local man, mga punkilito na lang nandiyan eh.
So punkilitos, na yan ang genre.
Well, then, you have the older guys who are still doing punk. Kasi punk naman, you know, you have people, you know, you still have Aldi Malanta, you still have Arnold Morales and Urban Bandits. You still have those guys around. But they're not playing, kasi punk was never supposed to be a musical genre.
Boy bands, it's pretty much dead. I think the whole K-pop movement took over in terms of, the Philippine scene.
But aren't they boy bands as well?
Pretty much,
but
yeah.
They're
but
Korean.
They're doing, But they're
so Korean
they and they're
boys,
doing
they're just,
more, yeah.
Yeah.
You're saying Koreans aren't boys?
I don't know, the homoerotic dance moves and, you know, the baby stuff. But it's
Baby, Justin Bieber.
Oh, yeah, Justin Bieber's like a one-man boy band.
That's true.
He's from a boy band. That's true. Yeah. But I think a lot of
Super Junior's not a boy band to you. Are they not made of boys?
I'm not so familiar with Super Junior. Yun yung magandang question. I think wala na masyado kasi ang ganda ng reaction ng mga tao when the AMAs this year when Backstreet Boys and New Kids on the Block did a collaboration.
Then everybody still there.
Yeah, everybody kind of like, well, remembered.
But it's like Sex Pistols playing at the Grammys, right? It's like it's
way
dead
to remember
still,
a dead
so it's
scene.
Like Gout.
Yeah. Well, yeah, going back.
So both boy bands and punk are like Gout.
Yeah.
Okay, glad that's been established. Acoustic, is that a genre even? Acoustic.
Well, if you're talking about the Paolo
Santos.
Noy Volante.
Si Noy Volante, the guy who looks like a Muppet. Yeah, yeah, that guy. I think that, but you know, that goes farther back than those guys.
Uh-huh.
I mean, you know, you have Jess Santiago, you have Noel Cabangon. Arguably, that's acoustic. One man with acoustic, it's a protest singer. Gary Granada. So it's very much alive.
Yes.
It probably won't get played on any, but basically, or wherever, it's probably going to be played where it was supposed to be played, in the streets.
Okay, let's talk about active rock.
It's basically, predominantly you got from Led Zeppelin, predominantly men looking at another guy with really tight pants and really, you know, taking off his shirt. Like the guy from Creed, diba? Religious, diba? Where parang the whole point of the show is when he talagang unleashes the glory of God by taking off his shirt.
So, can genres really die?
Well, yeah. It can recur. It can go in spurious ways. Like if you mentioned punk, it became hardcore. It became, you know.
I think it just fades into oblivion, a certain genre. Then the purists will still try to keep it there, but it's not gonna work really. But then, it always gets reincarnated. So we already end there.
Yeah, that's true. Okay, well, I guess in the end, genres can die, but that doesn't necessarily mean that bands have to die.
Mm-hmm.
Like, if you're a really good band, you can transcend the genre that defines you. And with that, we end
lesson
today's
learned.
Quickie with Erwin Romulo, Kim Arvilla, and me, Cor Canaris. We will see you next week.
All dressed up and nowhere to go?
We've got the lowdown on what to watch and what to avoid.
Judged solely, of course, with the greatest equalizer of them all, Hype.
This is Coming Soon.
First up, we have Mark Romanek's Never Let Me Go, adapted from the Kazuo Ishiguro book of the same name. A love triangle blossoms in a dystopian future where three friends are bred for their organs to be harvested. Carey Mulligan, new Spider-Man Andrew Garfield, and Keira Knightley star. Let Me Break It Down, it's Mark Romanek's third feature. It's written by Sunshine and 28 Days Later scribe Alex Garland. It's sci-fi, it's a love story. 5 out of 5.
Next, we have Burlesque, which tells a tale of a girl caught up in the exciting world of burlesque where she finds love, romance, and fulfillment. Cher and Christina Aguilera headline this glitzy musical. Everyone loves musicals, and we love us some Christina Aguilera and Cher. 3 out of 5.
Last, we have Tangled. It's a Disney retelling of the classic tale of Rapunzel, featuring Mandy Moore as the titular character and Chuck Zachary Levi as her dashing love interest. Not even a blip in our radars for a while, except for the Disney files. This shot up in hype because it's Quentin Tarantino's top 10 of 2010. What can we say? The man knows movies. 4 out of 5.
What's wrong, Cor?
I don't know. It's the end of the show, and I was thinking, you know, that there would be
more.
Yeah, I guess.
Yeah, that's what we do. You'll get used to it. It's always next week.
Oh, man, no.